don't mess with the chef when he's making his gravy. I thought you mother lovers understood that you were messing with Rosemary's baby.
Thousands of people on the island of Minando have moved to evacuation centres, and soldiers have been mobilised to help with the rescue efforts.
Uh-oh.
Gabriel Gage now has more details.
Storm power.
The people of the Philippines are no strangers to flooding, but Tropical Storm Washi caught the island of Mindanao by surprise. Most people were asleep when the flash floods struck on Friday night in the towns of Iligan and Cagayan de Oro. Rivers burned their banks. Residents searched desperately for higher ground. They found shelter where they could. Some were stranded on rooftops waiting to be rescued.
All we could see were lights flashing while we made a hole through our roof to climb out onto. We stayed on top of our roof the whole time.
Uh-oh. Look at this. Look at this.
Thousands of its soldiers are involved in the rescue effort, but for many, help has come too late. We found two bodies over here, the villager said, and three more over there, and now we're looking for the bodies in the neighboring village. The islands of the Philippines are battered by around 20 major storms every year.
Well, not 21.
Most take a more northerly route. Rescue workers say it's possible that the number of dead may be so high this time because the people of Mindanao simply aren't used to bearing the full brunt of 50-mile-an-hour winds like those of Tropical Storm Washi. Gabriel Gatehouse, BBC News.
Tropical Storm Washi.
Are you?
Amigos, it's that 2012 shit, yeah? I mean, today is what? What is today? Today is the 17th of December. That means a few more days until the dark power reaches its optimum. And then the light power starts to rise again. You see, that's the 21st of December, yeah? 21st of December is the equinox. I should know about these things, the equinox, because I was born on one. Anyway, amigos, stay tuned.
The Tropical Storm Washi swept across southern Philippines. Two major ports on the island of Mindanao were worst hit. An estimated 100,000 people had to flee their homes, and 20,000 soldiers are involved in a huge rescue operation.
Serious shit,
across
amigo.
The stricken north coast of the island. Damon Green reports.
It was a wall of water that crossed the land and took almost everything in its path. Driven by a tropical storm, the floodwaters wrecked roads and homes and swept lives away.
Look at that.
Heavy rainfall pushed up water levels by a meter in just 1 hour. And by the time they'd fallen, hundreds of lives had been lost and many thousands of people made homeless, despite efforts by the Filipino military to rescue whoever they could.
You know, the Navy and Coast Guard are flooding the areas, particularly in the between the river and the sea. But right now, we were able to rescue 18 people.
End of the world.
Part of the reason for the deadliness of these floods, the fact that they arrived at night. Many families in the Mindanao group of islands in the south of the Philippines were at home asleep, woken by the sound of rushing water. It was the lucky ones who managed to find transport to higher ground away from the worst danger, but the task of recovering the bodies of those killed has gone on all day, and with many washed out to sea, it could be many days before the final number of lives lost is known. Now that the storm has passed, the survivors are left with the task of assessing the damage and putting their lives back together. But with crops lost and much of the island's basic infrastructure now ruined for this already poor region, it will be a terrible struggle. David Green, ITV News.
Yeah. Go on, Michael. Yes, Michael.
Check your body out, do the same. Let's shout. Check your body out, do the same. Let's shout. Check your body out.
Michael. Michael, boom.